الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
استووا واعتدلوا الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين تتنزل عليهم الملائكة ألا تخافوا ولا تحزنوا وأبشروا بالجنة التي كنتم توعدون نحن أولياء ولهم فيها ما تشتهي أنفسكم ولكم فيها ما تدعون نزلا من غفور رحيم ومن أحسن قولا وعمل صالحا وقال إنني من المسلمين ولا تستوي الحسنة ولا السيئة ادفع بالتي هي أحسن فإذا الذي بينك وبينه عداوة كأنه ولي حميم وما يلقى صبر وما يلقاها إلا ذو حظ عظيم وإما ينزغنك من الشيطان نزغ فاستعذ بالله إنه هو السميع العليم الله سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. إن الذين قالوا ربنا الله ثم استقاموا فلا خوف عليهم ولا هم يحزنون. أولئك أصحاب الجنة خالدين فيها جزاء بما كانوا يعملون. الله سمع الله لمن حمده. الله الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. استغفر الله، استغفر الله، استغفر الله. اللهم أنت السلام.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله والسلام على رسول الله. وبعد, brothers and sisters, alhamdulillah, we are extremely honored and privileged to have esteemed guests with us to lead us in Salat al-Tarawih. We have Sheikh Zubayr Muhammad Ayyub Hafidhahullah, who will be leading us in Salat al-Tarawih, and also we have Sheikh Huzaifa Anwar as well from Bolton. So we are very extremely privileged and honored to have two esteemed guests to lead us in Tarawih. I will pass on the mic to Brother Raheem from Action, who will explain a few things about tonight's program, inshallah.
Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad. My dear brothers, everywhere I go, I do this, and I know half of SubhanAllah, we're almost in the last 10 days. So inshallah, please return this with a bit of alertness. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Wa alaikum
as-salam. SubhanAllah, everywhere I go, you get loud. You can tell the last day, SubhanAllah, so it's very nice to see. I'm sorry to introduce the Shaykh today, inshallah. Now, Shaykh Dr. Zubair bin Muhammad Ayub is an imam from Medina al-Munawwara and a professor at the prestigious Medina Islamic University of Saudi Arabia. Dr. Zubair is the son of the late imam of Masjid al-Nabawi, Shaykh Muhammad Ayub. Now, Shaykh Muhammad Ayub was, subhanAllah, the first imam of Medina al-Munawwara that was not of Arab origin. I think the UK was at the moment for two reasons. Number one, I don't think many people in the UK have heard of his recitation before. We'd love to share it. Three tours with different shayukh this year to go around. And number two, because it gives us an opportunity as a charity to come talk to you about our projects. And subhanAllah, all of Ramadan I've been focusing on different things, doing this and that. And for the last 2 days, I can only think about one thing. Wallahi, I can only think about one thing. Now, just to let you know as well, today, the Masjid has permitted us to do pledge style fundraising. I won't take more than 10 minutes of your time. And I promise you that I'll try and make it at least pleasant. Let me focus on the last few days. I'm sure you're all more aware of what's going on. And the reason it's hit me so hard is because I remember the first time in my life the concept of charity even entered my mind was in 2002, because I was in the news of it. Now, we sat there watching the news, and we were getting news about bombings. And my dad started wearing up. And he told me that the first time he ever did anything for charity, the first time he ever raised funds for another person, in the 60s, he was running school in his masjid. And since then, we have been asking for money for these same people. Since then, subhanAllah. Since 1948, there are brothers and sisters of ours that have had nothing other than what Muhammad has shared with them. And peace and salawat on the Prophet when I say his name. The reason that's important, brothers, is because when I tell you that they have nothing to share with them, I want you to understand something. When it comes time for iftar and children are hungry, they look outside and they see an olive tree. And they cannot go and take olives from that tree, even if it's in their own garden, because it does not belong to them. There are daughters of ours, children that have a 10, 15 minute walk to go to school in the morning. It takes them an hour because every 30 yards is another checkpoint. There are brothers and sisters of ours that wallahi cannot exit their own house. Imagine your door was sealed shut and they cannot exit their own home because the street outside their home is not permitted to walk on. They have to leave their houses through the windows, through the back door, walking through alleyways, subhanAllah, when there's a perfectly functioning road. Wallahi, a brother of mine has seen that road and he tells me it's empty. Nobody even walks on it. It's only there, the doors are only sealed shut so that the people know that they cannot have access to it. And that's why I'm here today. Because two nights ago, I was in Gravesend, London, and I was doing an appeal for water wells inside of Philistine. I was doing an appeal for water wells. Why? Because I knew before Ramadan that at some point or other, the water is going to get turned off. The water will be turned off in Gaza, and they will have nothing to drink. They'll have no water. And at that masjid, 2 days ago, I said to him, I can guarantee you, I said, well, by today, from today to the end of Ramadan, I guarantee things will escalate inside of Palestine. By the time I got back to the studio, SubhanAllah, on the Islam channel, I checked my phone, I was getting out of the car, and a good mood and appeal happening, I was ready for it. Got my phone out, and I was looking at my WhatsApp, and I already started getting messages about the bombings. 30 minutes. Within 30 minutes of me saying it, it began. And now I stand here before you, and you already know what's happening inside Palestine, and you already know that it's going to get worse. The last 10 nights without fail in the last 10 nights, they stormed Masjid al-Aqsa. Now what we want to do is something very, very simple. We want to make sure that before anything like that happens, alhamdulillah, many communities have come forward already. We want to make sure anything like that happens, we have food, we have water, we have medicine ready. Because when there is nothing, at least some of us will be there to provide it. It costs roughly £500 to make sure that one family has everything for the entire month. And that isn't just food and water for the iftar and the suhoor, that includes includes medicine, but we make sure that the option is there in case they need it. We make sure that clinics are set up. Now, it costs £500 for each of these. Well, I would like to ask my brothers, alhamdulillah, the sisters have machines and buckets. Unfortunately, we couldn't leave any pledge forms with you. Any of the brothers that are here today, what I ask of you, is there anyone here willing to pledge £1,000 to make sure that two families inside of Palestine are guaranteed to have what they need to survive until the end of Ramadan at least? I appreciate you look at this and you think to ourselves, £1,000, that is a lot of money. And I get it, wallahi, I get it. Because the first time I ever did anything like this, I was raising £500 and I spoke to 10 of my cousins and asked them for £50 each. And I know I'm Pakistani, I don't know about everyone else, but we've got cousins by the dozens. Spend money tonight. You don't have to say to Raheel, I'm giving you £10,000 right now. As long as you say to me and you put your hand up and say, you know what, Raheel, we'll try and do something. I can tell our team that I'll do families, put the money aside, send it across, the brothers will provide it. Because every single time we do this, brothers provide. So I ask again, and I'm only going to ask three times for everything, brothers, because I don't want to waste your time. I want to enjoy the Sheikh's recitations, and I don't like to make them fill in a form because they don't want to put their hand up in front of everyone else, and I understand that. So I ask another time, brothers, is there anyone that's willing to pledge £1,000, inshallah, to raise funds for these families? Two families, inshallah, with water, food, and medicine. The final time I'll ask my brothers, is there anyone today willing to pledge and say, you know what, we will try. As a family, I'll speak to my cousin, I'll at least try. Is there anyone, my brothers, that's willing to pledge £1,000? Alhamdulillah, jazakallah khair. Don't be without your dad looking at. Brothers, is there anyone willing to take on one family and give one family at least this Ramadan everything that they could need? £500, inshallah, to provide for one family. Anyone at all? If you keep doing that, they're going to bring you a form, you know. Alhamdulillah. Anyone at all, brothers? Just £500. And you don't have to do it now. If you say to me, look, I'm going to do £50 a month for the next 10 months. I'm going to speak to my family, we'll save 10 months, we can do £50 each. That's fine. I'll tell the team to send the money. We know that one family is safe today. I've asked twice already, so for the third time, brothers, is there anyone at all willing to pledge £500 between now and the rest of the year, the rest of the month? Alhamdulillah, one brother at the back. For the two brothers, one at the front as well here. But every time someone puts their hand up, we always give takbir. So please, for the first one at least, takbir. Alhamdulillah. One brother here. Since two brothers came forward, I'll ask the final time, brothers. Is there anyone else willing to pledge just £500 to fill in a form? Jazakallah khair, I appreciate it. The final thing I'll ask of you, because I really want to enjoy the Taraweeh today. The final thing I'll ask of you is, for one more family, is there two brothers willing to do £250 each to make sure that we can provide one more family? We've got two families taken care of. It'd be nice if I can go back and say that we've done three, because we know how Allah SWT loves things in odd numbers. So is there anyone else with us for the final ask for £250, inshallah, between two of us? Alhamdulillah. Jazakallah khair, brothers. I appreciate that this is not always the best method. And I appreciate that many of you will donate on your way out. And I also appreciate that many, many of you will fill in forms on your way out, inshallah. So I want to say jazakallah khair. If there's anything you want to know about the work that we do, please ask. And bear in mind that everything we raise today, whether you give by card or cash, or whether you come speak to us at the end to take bank details, whatever it is, we will make sure that it goes to people inside Palestine. People that, as I said earlier, without us, they will have nothing. Now, the last thing I would like to say before I go, brothers, is I know that times are hard. Genuinely, I do, subhanAllah, because sometimes I look at my statement at the end of the month and I don't know what I'm looking at anymore. And I appreciate that completely, and I want to share the words of one scholar before I go. Unfortunately, I forgot his name because I didn't have enough time to double check before Salah today. But when things were difficult for the Muslims, and they could no longer afford to live, people came to him and complained and they said, what do we do? The price of rice is more than we can afford. We cannot afford flour. We cannot spend our time walking to get water because when we come back there will be no one at our shops. What do we do? And the scholar turned to them and said, wallahi, the same one who provided for you when prices were low is the one that will provide for you now that prices are high. Everywhere you go, fundraisers tell you something fundamental, that is, sadaqah does not increase your wealth, because what you give will be returned to you in this life and the next, inshallah. So please bear that in mind as you leave the person. Jazakallah khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين هود ألا تتقون إني لكم رسول أمين فاتقوا الله وأطيعون وما أسألكم عليه من أجر إن أجري إلا على رب العالمين أتبنون بكل ريع آية تعبثون وتتخذون مصانع لعلكم تخلدون وإذا بطشتم جبارين فاتقوا الله وأطيعون واتقوا الذي أمدكم بما تعملون واتقوا الذي أمدكم بما تعلمون أمدكم بأموال وبنين وجنات وعيون إني أخاف عليكم عذاب يوم عظيم قالوا سواء علينا أوعظت أم لم تكن من الواعظين إن هذا خلق الأولين وما نحن بمعذبين فكذبوه فأهلكناهم إن في ذلك لآية وما كان أكثرهم مؤمنين وإن ربك لهو العزيز الرحيم الله سمع الله لمن حمده الله الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين كذبت ثمود المرسلين إذ قال لهم أخوهم صالح ألا تتقون إني لكم رسول أمين فاتقوا الله وأطيعون وما أسألكم عليه من أجر إن أجري إلا على رب العالمين أتتركون فيما هاهنا آمنين وتنحتون من الجبال بيوتا فارهين فاتقوا الله وأطيعون. قالوا إنما أنت من المسحرين ما أنت إلا بشر مثلنا فأت بآية إن كنت من الصادقين. قال هذه ناقة لها شرب ولكم شرب يوم معلوم ولا تمسوها بسوء فيأخذكم عذاب عظيم. فعقروها فأصبحوا نادمين فأخذهم العذاب إن في العزيز الرحيم. الله سمع الله لمن حمده. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
في آية قفزتها؟ من الذي يتابع؟ في آية
الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا قوم لوط المرسلين إذ قال لهم أخوهم لوط ألا تتقون إنكم رسول أمين فاتقوا الله وأطيعون وما أسألكم عليه من أجر إن أجري إلا على رب العالمين أتأتون الذكران من العالمين وتذرون ما خلق لكم ربكم من أزواجكم بل أنتم قوم عادون قالوا لئن لم تنته قال إني لعملكم من القالين رب نجني وأهلي مما يعملون فنجيناه وأهله أجمعين إلا عجوزا في الغابرين وأمطرنا عليهم مطرا إلا عجوزا في الغابرين فنجيناه وأهله أجمعين إلا عجوزا في الغابرين ثم دمرنا الآخرين وأمطرنا عليهم مطرا فساء الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا كذب أصحاب الأيكة المرسلين إذ قال لهم شعيب أتتقون إني لكم رسول أمين فاتقوا الله وأطيعون وما أسألكم عليه من أجر إن أجري إلا على رب العالمين أوفوا الكيل ولا تكونوا من المخسرين وزنوا بالقسطاس المستقيم ولا تبخسوا الناس أشياءهم ولا تبخسوا الناس أشياءهم أنت من المسحرين وما أنت إلا بشر مثلنا وإنك لمن الكاذبين فأسقط لنا كسفا من السماء إن كنت من الصادقين قال ربي أعلم بما تعملون فكذبوه فأخذهم عذاب يوم الظلة إنه كان عذاب يوم عظيم إن في ذلك لآية وما كان أكثر المؤمنين وإن ربك لهو العزيز الرحيم الله سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. وإنه لتنزيل رب العالمين، نزل به الروح الأمين على قلبك لتكون من المنذرين، بلسان عربي مبين، وإنه لفي زبر الأولين. أولم يكن لهم آية أن يعلمه علماء بني إسرائيل، ولو نزلناه على بعض الأعجمين، فقرأه عليهم ما كانوا به مؤمنين. كذلك سلكناه في قلوب المجرمين، لا يؤمنون به حتى يروا العذاب الأليم، فيأتيهم وهم لا يشعرون، فيقولوا هل نحن منظرون، أفبعذابنا يستعجلون. الله 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 أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. أفبعذابنا يستعجلون أفرأيت إن متعناهم سنين ثم جاء من المؤمنين فإن عصوك فقل إني بريء مما تعملون. الله سمع الله الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. وتوكل على العزيز الرحيم الذي يراك حين تقوم وتقلبك في الساجدين إنه هو السميع العليم. هل أنبئكم على تنزل على كل أفاك أثيم يُلْقُونَ السَّمْعَ وَأَكْثَرُهُمْ كَاذِبُونَ وَالشُّعَرَاءُ يَتَّبِعُهُمُ الْغَاوُونَ أَلَمْ تَرَ أَنَّهُمْ فِي كُلِّ وَادٍ يَهِيمُونَ وَأَنَّهُمْ يَقُولُونَ مَا لَا سيعلم الذين ظلموا أي منقلب ينقلبون الله سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين بسم الله طاسين تلك آيات القرآن وكتاب مبين هدى وبشرى للمؤمنين الذين يقيمون الصلاة ويؤتون الزكاة وهم بالآخرة هم يوقنون إن الذين لا يؤمنون بالآخرة زينا لهم أعمالهم فهم يعمهون أولئك الذين لهم سوء العذاب وهم في الآخرة هم الأخسرون وإنك لتلقى القرآن من لدن حكيم عليم إذ قال موسى لأهله إني آنست نارا سآتيكم منها بخبر أو آتيكم بشهاب قبس لعلكم تصطلون فلما جاءها نودي أن بورك من في النار ومن حولها وسبحان الله رب العالمين يا موسى إنه أنا الله العزيز الحكيم وألق عصاك فلما رآها تهتز كأنها جان ولا مدبرا ولم يعقب يا موسى لا تخف إني لا يخاف لدي المرسلون إلا من ظلم ثم بدل حسنا بعد سوء فإني غفور رحيم وأدخل يدك في جيبك تخرج بيضاء من غير سوء في تسع آيات إلى فرعون وقومه إنهم كانوا قوما فاسقين. فلما جاءتهم آياتنا مبصرة قالوا هذا سحر مبين. وجحدوا بها واستيقنتها أنفسهم ظلما وعلوا فانظر كيف كان عاقبة المفسدين. يا الله لمن حمده. الله الله أكبر الله أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. ولقد آتينا داود وسليمان علما وقال الحمد لله الذي فضلنا من عباده المؤمنين. وورث سليمان داود وقال يا أيها الناس علمنا منطق الطير وأوتينا من كل شيء إن هذا لهو الفضل المبين. وحشر لسليمان جنوده من الجن والإنس والطير فهم يوزعون. حتى إذا أتوا على واد النمل قالت نملة يا أيها النمل ادخلوا مساكنكم لا يحطمنكم سليمان وجنوده وهم لا يشعرون. فتبسم ضاحكا من قولها وقال رب أوزعني أن أشكر نعمتك التي أنعمت علي وعلى والدي وأن أعمل صالحا ترضاه وأدخلني برحمتك في عبادك الصالحين. وتفقد الطير فقال ما لي لا أرى الهدهد أم كان من الغائبين. لأعذبنه عذابا شديدا أو لأذبحنه أو ليأتيني بسلطان مبين.
الله أكبر.
سمع الله لمن حمده.
الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر.
الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. فمكث غير بعيد فقال أحطت بما لم تحط به وجئتك من سبأ بنبأ يقين. إني وجدت امرأة تملكهم وأوتيت من كل شيء ولها عرش عظيم. وجدتها وقومها يسجدون للشمس من دون الله وزين لهم الشيطان أعمالهم فصدهم عن السبيل فهم لا يهتدون. ألا يسجدوا لله الذي يخرج الخبأ في السماوات والأرض ويعلم ما تخفون وما تعلنون. الله لا إله إلا هو رب العرش العظيم.
الله أكبر.
قال سننظر أصدقت أم كنت من الكاذبين. اذهب بكتابي هذا فألقه إليهم ثم تول عنهم فانظر ماذا يرجعون. قالت يا أيها الملأ إني ألقي إلي كتاب كريم. إنه من سليمان وإنه بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ألا تعلوا علي وأتوني مسلمين.
الله أكبر.
سمع الله لمن حمده.
الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. قالت يا أيها الملأ أفتوني في أمري ما كنت قاطعة أمرا حتى تشهدون. قالوا نحن أولو قوة وأولو بأس شديد والأمر إليك فانظري ماذا تأمرين. قالت إن الملوك إذا دخلوا قرية أفسدوها وجعلوا أعزة أهلها أذلة وكذلك يفعلون. وإني مرسلة إليهم بهدية فناظرة بما يرجع المرسلون. فلما جاء سليمان قال أتمدونني بمال فما آتاني الله خير مما آتاكم بل أنتم بهديهم فلنأتينهم بجنود لا قبل لهم بها ولنخرجنهم منها أذلة وهم صاغرون. قال يا أيها الملأ أيكم يأتيني بعرشها قبل أن يأتوني مسلمين. قال عفريت من الجن أنا آتيك به قبل أن تقوم من مقامك. قال الذي عنده علم من الكتاب أنا آتيك به قبل أن يرتد إليك طرفك. فلما رآه مستقرا عنده قال هذا من فضل ربي ليبلوني أأشكر أم أكفر. ومن شكر فإنما يشكر لنفسه ومن كفر فإن ربي غني كريم. قال نكروا لها عرشها
فننظر أتهتدي أم تكون من الذين لا يهتدون. فلما جاءت قيل أهكذا عرشك؟ قالت كأنه هو وأوتينا العلم من قبلها وكنا مسلمين. وصدها ما كانت تعبد من دون الله إنها كانت من قوم رأته حسبته لجة وكشفت عن ساقيها قال إنه صرح ممرد من قوارير. قالت رب إني ظلمت نفسي وأسلمت مع سليمان لله رب العالمين. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. ولقد أرسلنا إلى ثمود أخاهم صالحا أن اعبدوا الله فإذا هم فريقان يختصمون. قال يا قوم لم تستعجلون بالسيئة قبل الحسنة لولا تستغفرون الله لعلكم ترحمون. قالوا اطيرنا بك وبمن معك؟ قال طائركم عند الله بل أنتم قوم تفتنون. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. وكان في المدينة تسعة رهط يفسدون في الأرض ولا يصلحون. قالوا تقاسموا بالله لنبيتنه وأهله ثم لنقولن لوليه ما شهدنا مهلك أهله وإنا لصادقون. ومكروا مكرا ومكرنا مكرا وهم لا يشعرون. كيف كان عاقبة مكرهم أنا دمرناهم وقومهم أجمعين. فتلك بيوتهم خاوية بما ظلموا، إن في ذلك لآية لقوم يعلمون. وأنجينا الذين آمنوا وكانوا يتقون.
الله أكبر.
سمع الله لمن حمده.
الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر.
الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. ولوطا إذ قال لقومه أتأتون الفاحشة وأنتم تبصرون. أئنكم لتأتون الرجال شهوة من دون النساء، بل أنتم قوم تجهلون. فما كان جواب قومه إلا أن قالوا أخرجوا آل لوط من قريتكم، إنهم أناس يتطهرون. فأنجيناه وأهله إلا امرأته قدرناها من الغابرين. وأمطرنا عليهم مطرا فساء مطر المنذرين. قل الحمد لله وسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى. الله خير أما يشركون.
الله أكبر.
سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا السماوات والأرض وأنزل لكم من السماء ماء فأنبتنا به حدائق ذات بهجة ما كان لكم أنبتوا شجرها أإله مع الله بل هم قوم يعدلون أمن جعل الأرض قرارا وجعل خلالها أنهارا وجعل بين البحرين حاجزا أإله مع الله بل أكثرهم لا يعلمون أمن يجيب المضطر إذا يكشف السوء ويجعلكم خلفاء الأرض أإله مع الله قليلا ما تذكرون أمن يهديكم في ظلمات البر والبحر ومن يرسل الرياح بشرا بين يدي رحمته أإله مع الله تعالى الله عما يشركون أمن يبدأ الخلق ثم يعيده ومن يرزقكم من السماء والأرض أإله مع الله قل هاتوا برهانكم إن كنتم صادقين قل لا يعلم من في السماوات والأرض الغيب إلا الله وما يشعرون أيان يبعثون بل ادارك علمهم في الآخرة بل هم في شك منها بل هم
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. وقال الذين كفروا أئذا كنا ترابا وآباؤنا إنا لمخرجون، لقد وعدنا هذا نحن من قبل إن هذا إلا أساطير الأولين. قل سيروا في الأرض فانظروا كيف كان عاقبة المجرمين، ولا تحزن عليهم ولا تك في ضيق مما يمكرون. ويقولون متى هذا الوعد إن كنتم صادقين. قل عسى أن يكون ردف لكم بعض الذي تستعجلون، وإن ربك لذو فضل على الناس ولكن أكثرهم لا يشكرون. وإن ربك ليعلم ما تكن صدورهم وما يعلنون. وما من غابة في السماء والأرض إلا في كتاب مبين. وما من غائبة في السماء والأرض إلا في كتاب مبين. إن هذا القرآن يقص على بني إسرائيل أكثر الذي هم فيه يختلفون. وإنه لهدى ورحمة للمؤمنين. إن ربك يقضي بينهم بحكمه وهو العزيز العليم. إنك لا تسمع الموتى ولا تسمع الصم الدعاء إذا ولوا مدبرين. وما أنت بهاد العمي عن ضلالتهم، إن تسمع إلا من يؤمن بآياتنا فهم مسلمون. وإذا وقع القول عليهم أخرجنا لهم دابة من الناس أن الناس كانوا بآياتنا لا يوقنون.
وإذا وقع القول عليهم
أخرجنا لهم دابة من الناس من الأرض أن تكلم الناس أن الناس كانوا بآياتنا لا يوقنون.
الله أكبر.
سمع الله لمن حمده.
الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر.
Yeah.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين وإذا وقع القول عليهم أخرجنا لهم من الأرض تكلمهم أن الناس كانوا بآياتنا لا يوقنون ويوم نحشر من كل أمة فوجا ممن يكذب بآياتنا فهم يوزعون حتى إذا ما جاءوا قال أكذبتم بآياتي ولم تحيطوا بها علما أم ماذا كنتم تعملون ووقع القول عليه ظلموا فهم لا ينطقون ألم يروا أنا جعلنا ليسكنوا فيه والنهار مبصرا إن في ذلك لآيات لقوم يؤمنون ويوم ينفخ في الصور ففزع من في السماوات ومن في الأرض إلا من شاء الله وكل أتوه داخلين وترى الجبال تحسبها جامدة وهي تمر مر السحاب صنع الله الذي أتقن كل شيء إنه خبير بما تفعلون من جاء بالحسنة فله خير منها وهم من فزع يومئذ آمنون ومن جاء بالسيئة فكبت وجوههم في النار هل تجزون إلا كنتم تعملون الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين إنما أمرت أن أعبد رب هذه البلدة الذي حرمها وله كل شيء وأمرت أن أكون من المسلمين وأن أتلو القرآن فمن اهتدى فإنما يهتدي لنفسه ومن ضل فقل إنما أنا من المنذرين وقل الحمد لله سيريكم آياته فتعرفونها وما ربك بغافل عما تعملون الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. طسم. تلك آيات الكتاب المبين، نتلو عليك من نبأ موسى وفرعون بالحق لقوم يؤمنون. إن فرعون علا في الأرض وجعل أهلها شيعا يستضعف طائفة منهم يذبح أبناءهم ويستحيي نساءهم، إنه كان من المفسدين. ونريد أن نمن على الذين استضعفوا في الأرض ونجعلهم أئمة ونجعلهم الوارثين. ونمكن لهم في الأرض ونري فرعون وهامان وجنودهما أن أرضعيه، فإذا خفت عليه فألقيه في اليم ولا تخافي ولا تحزني، إنا رادوه إليك وجاعلوه من المرسلين. فالتقطه آل فرعون ليكون لهم عدوا وهزنا، إن فرعون وهامان وجنودهما كانوا خاطئين. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. وقالت امرأة فرعون قرة عين لي ولك، لا تقتلوه عسى أن ينفعنا أو نتخذه ولدا وهم لا يشعرون. وأصبح فؤاد أم موسى فارغا، إن كادت لتبدي به لولا أن ربطنا على قلبها لتكون من المؤمنين. وقالت لأخته قصيه، فبصرت به عن جنب وهم لا يشعرون. وحرمنا عليه المراضع من قبل فقالت هل ندلكم على أهل بيت يكفلونه لكم وهم له ناصحون. فرددناه إلى أمه كي تقر عينها ولا تحزن ولتعلم أن وعد الله حق ولكن أكثرهم لا يعلمون. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
الشيخ ابن ليلي صلاة الوتر. The witr salah is slightly different from taslim. And after the ruku he goes into dua prunut loudly. So it's a slightly different way of performing the salat al-witr. They're both valid, they're both from the sunnah. And after the Salat al-Witr, there will be a short talk from Sheikh Zubair.
الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. سبح اسم ربك الأعلى الذي خلق فسوى، والذي قدر فهدى، والذي أخرج المرعى، فجعله غثاء أحوى، سنقرئك فلا تنسى، إلا ما شاء الله، إنه يعلم الجهر وما يخفى، ويسرك لليسرى، فذكر إن نفعت الذكرى، سيذكر من يخشى، ويتجنبها الأشقى، الذي يصلى النار الكبرى، ثم لا يموت فيها ولا يحيا، قد أفلح من تزكى، وذكر اسم ربه فصلى، بل تؤثرون الحياة الدنيا، والآخرة خير وأبقى، إن هذا لفي الصحف الأولى، صحف إبراهيم وموسى. الله سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين،
إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. قل يا أيها الكافرون لا أعبد ما تعبدون ولا أنتم عابدون ما أعبد ولا أنا عابد ما عبدتم ولا أنتم عابدون ما أعبد لكم دينكم ولي دين الله. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد الله سمع الله لمن حمده اللهم اهدنا فيمن هديت وعافنا فيمن عافيت وتولنا فيمن توليت وبارك لنا فيما أعطيت وقنا واصرف عنا برحمتك شر ما قضيت اللهم يا ميسر الأمور يسر أمورنا واشرح صدورنا ونور قلوبنا واختم بالصالحات أعمالنا وبالسعادة آجالنا اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك ربنا سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات. اللهم إنا نسألك من الخير كله عاجله وآجله، ما علمنا منه وما لم نعلم، ونعوذ بك من الشر كله عاجله وآجله، ما علمنا منه وما لم نعلم. اللهم حبب إلينا الإيمان وزينه في قلوبنا، وكره إلينا الكفر والفسوق والعصيان، واجعلنا من الراشدين. اللهم إنا نسألك الجنة ونعيمها وما قرب إليها من قول أو عمل، ونعوذ بك من النار وما قرب إليها من قول أو عمل. اللهم اغفر لنا وارحمنا وأعتق رقابنا من النار. اللهم تقبل منا الصيام والقيام. اللهم تقبل صيامنا وصلاتنا ودعاءنا، واجعلنا مباركين أينما كنا. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. وصل اللهم وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. سبحان الملك القدوس. سبحان الملك القدوس. سبحان الملك.
Brothers and sisters, alhamdulillah, it was a great honor to pray salat behind Sheikh Zubair ibn Muhammad ibn Ayyub. He is an amazing reciter, and alhamdulillah, we feel it was a privilege to pray behind him. Sheikh Muhammad Ayyub, he was the former Imam of Masjid al-Nabawi al-Sharif, and his recitation is well known. And most of us here, those who are hafiz, listening to the recitation of Sheikh. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant Sheikh Muhammad Ayyub a highest place in Jannah, and Allah have mercy on him. Alhamdulillah, it was a great honor to be in his presence, inshallah.
نشأنا نستمع إلى يعني صوت أبيك، يعني نشأنا استماع إلى الله يرحمه رحمة واسعة.
هذا خليفة الشيخ محمد
ما شاء الله، هو يعني نقل ما شاء الله.
صوت جميل ما شاء الله. الله يحفظه. هو إمام خلاص، إمام.
لا هو زائر مثلك ما شاء
الله. صوت جميل. الله يفتح عليك.
جزاك الله خير يا شيخ. بارك الله فيك.
تمشي
انت تمشي انا مانشستر اوكي
مانشستر ساعه ساعه
وربع اوكي ان شاء الله بارك الله فيكم اوكي شيخ ننتقل الى
غرفه ايش كده وقت
You off heading off now? Do you want
to?
Yeah, he wants
to go. Okay. JazakAllah khair.
شرفتنا. أبدا أنا سعيد جدا. سعيد جدا. ونتمنى أن تزورنا في 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 المستقبل إن شاء الله.
إن شاء الله. إن شاء الله. ما شاء الله. الله يفتح عليك. لندن.
Thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the benefits that He has granted us. It's a such a wonderful ni'mah, a blessing, to be sitting in this masjid, praying Salat al-Taraweeh, listening to the beautiful recitation. Alhamdulillah. Say Alhamdulillah. Always be grateful for the ni'mah Allah has given you. If you be grateful, لَإِن شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ. If you're grateful, Allah will give you more. If you're grateful, Allah will grant you more. Allah will give you more. Once this sister, she came to me and she was complaining about her husband. She said, I come home, I'm doing everything. He's not doing anything at all. You know, like women, most they listen to stress. We doing all the work, he doesn't do anything. So this particular sister, she's complaining about her husband. He goes with his friends, he goes out, and I'm looking after the children, I'm cleaning them, I'm bathing them, I'm feeding them, I'm putting them to bed, I'm doing all the work, I'm doing all the work, he does nothing. You know, tell him, every time I see him, I should say astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah, because he makes me work so hard. I should say astaghfirullah. And when he sees me, he should say alhamdulillah. You have to be very careful what you're asking for. Because if I tell my brother, every time he says alhamdulillah and thank Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لَإِنْ شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ, maybe that Allah will be grateful for his thanking, and Allah will give him another wife. Because Allah is the double. She became a little bit quiet. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, being grateful, Allah will grant you more. Alhamdulillah, we have this great beautiful recitation. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Such wonderful recitation. My brother asked me, he said, why don't you read two rak'ats of Salat Taraweeh? My brother asked me, I said, how can I deprive you from this beautiful recitation when this is going on? My tune, where's my child, no style, I have no scripture, I have no tune, nothing. Let them recite the prayers. MashaAllah, it was worth listening to. It reminds me when Hazrat Sheikh Rashid Ahmad Dangohi, rahmatullahi alayhi, when he was during his final years, he was very old. And so he asked someone to lead Salat al-Taraweeh in his final year. And Hazrat Sheikh Zakariya rahmatullahi alayhi's father, Hazrat Mawlana Yahya rahmatullahi alayhi, he was a middle-aged young man. And he was there, and he was a hafid. So he asked Rashid Ahmad Dangohi rahmatullahi alayhi, he asked, is there anyone who can lead the Taraweeh this year? Because the usual person who leads the Taraweeh, he can't do it this year. So who's going to lead the Salat al-Taraweeh? So nobody, everybody's afraid. Nobody's putting their hands up. So Rashid Ahmad Dangohi rahmatullahi alayhi, Hazrat, he pointed out to Yahya rahmatullahi alayhi. He said, Yahya, aren't you a hafiz? Why don't you lead the Salat al-Taraweeh? So Hazrat, MashaAllah, the other one was very good. I don't think I can do it. Hazrat Yahya himself said, I was so nervous. I was so anxious. I was so nervous. I had to look into the Quran to revise. Now, this for me only seemed usual. Before this, he had never looked at the Quran to revise. He knew the Quran so well, so well. He was so proficient, so efficient, so strong in his memorization that he never looked at the Quran to recite. He was so nervous that I had to look in the Quran and revise the first and quarter chapter. And then I led the Salat al-Taraweeh. Then after that, once I was calm, then I didn't need to look into the Quran. I led the entire Taraweeh. Mawlana Yahya himself says that I became a hafiz at the age of 7. At the age of 7, he became hafiz. As soon as he became hafiz, for 6 months, kids, listen to this. Who's 7 years old? Anybody 7 years old? MashaAllah, 7 years old. Mawlana Yahya was 7 years old when he became a hafiz. He said that after he became hafiz, for six months, every day he completed one entire Quran recitation. Looking inside. For 6 months after becoming hafiz, this is a 7-year-old I'm talking about. Now you do the math. How many completions did he make? During the 6 months, every day he would recite the entire Quran on a daily basis. That's why his Quran was so strong, so strong. Subhanallah. He would recite, from then on, he would recite the Quran from memory. He did not need to look inside the Quran. That's why he said, I was so stressed, I had to look at the Quran when Hazrat asked me to read the prayers. When Ramadan came, Quran was the forefront. Quran was everything. Mawlana Yahya would go from masajid to masajid, from mosque to mosque, reciting the Quran. He would complete the entire recitation in 3 nights. In Salat al-Taraweeh, 3 nights. People would invite him. Mawlana Yahya, come to my masjid. And they were challenging him, who can catch his mistake. Yes, challenge each other. Who can catch the mistake? He was so, so well memorized. One time in Delhi, he went to this masjid, Mawlana Yahya. He went to this masjid, and this particular Hafiz Imam Sahib was leading the prayers. In his fourth rakat, he was reciting the 14th juz. And in the fourth rakat, he was doing some in the fourth rakat. Mawlana Yahya, shall I lead the prayers? Shall I lead the prayers? So Imam Sahib said, by all means, yes, of course, by all means. Mawlana Yahya took over on the fifth rakat. I remember what juz was on 14th juz. He started reciting from the 15th juz. In the next 16th, I wonder how the Muqtadis were, they were very tired about probably listening to the entire 16th juz. Alhamdulillah, the Quran recitation is finished in the month of Ramadan. But this was their love for recitation. Ya Allah, look at the ulama, look at the scholars, how much love they had for recitation of the Quran.
Request the owner of VW Golf KV60FPU to be moved to that floor.
That's good.
So please remove the car because it might be obstructing somebody else. Please do remove it. So these ulama, you know, their love for the heart for the Quran, especially the Ramadan, the amount of recitation they used to do, even those ulama who were not Hafiz. Haji Abdullah, or Sheikh al-Hind. Sheikh al-Hind, he wasn't a Hafiz, but he loved to sit, mindful not to cause anyone difficulty. So what he used to do is to ask two people to come and recite, and he would recite behind them. When they finished, they left, somebody else came, and they recited. Sheikh al-Hind would listen behind them and pray behind them. Once they left, another couple came. Like that, the entire night would pass, Sheikh al-Hind would continue praying. That his feet will swell. His feet will swell and he will say Alhamdulillah. And you'll be happy that his feet has been swollen. Why? Because he has acted upon the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because he read the hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would stand in prayer and would stand so long that his feet will swell. So he was happy that his feet had swollen. This is the love these ulama had for the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Suffering in pain for the sake of sunnah was beloved to them. And he was very mindful not to cause anybody any grief or any pain. You know, the people, the household, the women in the house, they felt sorry for Sheikh al-Hind. They thought, bichara, you know, he's standing there, his feet are swollen, he's continuing. Somebody tell somebody to stop leading the prayers. If somebody stops leading the prayers, he'll stop standing there with his swollen feet. So towards the final years, there was this one particular Sheikh, he used to do the prayers for Sheikh al-Hind. So some of the women came and told him, said, let's go. That's enough, you know. Tell Sheikh al-Hind, make some excuse and say, Sheikh, tonight this is enough, take some rest. I'm very tired, I can't eat today. Inshallah, some other time. Tomorrow, inshallah. So bichara, he was forced, the imam was forced. So he told Sheikh al-Hind, Sheikh, you know, I'm really tired today. I'm feeling very well. My feet are aching. You know, we'll continue tomorrow, inshallah. Sheikh al-Hind was very careful not to hurt anybody, right? That could not cause anybody any difficulty. He said, okay, that's no problem. You go and rest. So the imam, he went to sleep. Middle of the night, he's woken up by someone pressing his feet, doing malish on his feet. He wakes up and he sees Sheikh al-Hind pressing his feet. He jumps up and says, Hazrat, why are you doing? What are you doing? Because, Ya Allah, you told me your feet are hurting. So, you know, I should do some khidmat for you. I should do some malish for you. You said your feet are hurting. I need to do some malish. Allahu Akbar. This is the humbleness. This is the humbleness. Love the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But don't cause the people pain because you want to act upon the sunnah of Rasulullah. Allah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increase their status in Jannah. Ameen. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward them immensely. Ameen. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow us to follow their footsteps. Ameen. And the footsteps of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My dear friends, I was here to talk about Ramadan. You know, how much time do I have? I won't take much time. I promise not to put you to sleep, so that's why I'll be very quick. I don't get invited very quickly, so I'll take both of my time. Ramadan, fasting. You know, we should not underestimate the significance, the power, the importance of Ramadan, and the acts of worship that are performed within the month of Ramadan. My dear friends, Ramadan is such a great blessing, great blessing. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Ramadan has been made compulsory upon you, like it was made compulsory on the nation before you. Now what does that say? Fasting is something universal. Everybody used to fast. The Christians fasted, the Jews fasted. The Hindus fast. The atheists, they fast. They don't believe in anyone and they fast. Because fasting is so unique. It has something for everybody. There are so many medical benefits, physical benefits. Dr. Saab will tell you all the benefits are, physical benefits of fasting are. It regulates a certain, you know, blood pressure, and it kills off toxins, and your weight, etc. There's so many health benefits. But as Muslims, we don't look at those health benefits. Those are side benefits. Those are secondary issues. Our primary aim, our objective, is to become close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Become a muttaqi. Become a God-fearing person. Become a good servant of Allah. Become a wali of Allah. Our objectives are the spiritual benefits that will benefit us in this world and the hereafter. The medical, alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah. They are secondary benefits. But fasting is so unique. It's so unique. It's not like any other worship. If you think about all the a'mal that we do, all the good deeds that we do as Muslims, most of them are actions, outward actions. When we pray salah, we perform something. When we give zakah, we're doing an action, right? When we perform hajj, we're doing something. When you fast, you don't do anything. It's an omission. There's nothing to be shown from the outside. Hence Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, As-sawmu li wa ana ajzi bih. The fasting is for me and I shall reward them for it. Because of course Allah is going to reward everything that nobody else can reward. Allah will reward inshallah for all the deeds that you do. But He specifically chose fasting because it's unique. Muhaddithin have said that another interpretation of this is that fasting, all other acts of worship, when you do something, there's a slight possibility that there may be some, you know, riya in there, some showing off. You're doing something that you're, so someone can see you doing something. You're doing an act of donating, why? So somebody can see you. In fasting, because you don't do anything, there's no possibility or implication that you're doing to show off something. Hence, it's only for the sake of Allah. That's why he says, As-sawmu li, it's only for Allah. But fasting, subhanallah, you know, we, as Muslims, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow us to understand the true significance of fasting. Ameen. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow us to understand the true significance and the importance of fasting. My dear brothers, fasting has been there before us, before Islam. Why? Because it has a role to play in every society. It can deal with the problems of every single age, and this current age that we live in a very dangerous time. We live in the most severe age of any time in Islamic history. Our Hazrat Mawlana Yusuf Mutala rahmatullahi alayhi said, few years before he passed away, he said, we live in a time where the fitna is so intense. Never had we faced such fitna since the time Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as the Prophet of Allah. Never. The trials and the tribulations that we face today, never in history has been faced. We face today all types of fitna. All types of fitna. Recite the Quran, you recite the Quran, yeah? You read the stories of Anbiya, yeah? You read the stories of Thamud, Ad, Qawm Lut, and all the evil deeds that they used to commit. Think about it. All those fitnas, all those deeds are here in this time and age. We are facing them right now, all together. Think about the trials and tribulations. Rasulullah and the Sahaba, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the Sahaba radiallahu anhum, the trials that they faced, we are facing them today. Collective, all of them. My dear brothers, we need Allah's help. The odds are all against us. What day was it? 17th of Ramadan? The Battle of Badr? Take inspiration from that. Take inspiration from the Battle of Badr. The Battle of Badr, for those who don't know, read about it. Learn about it. The Battle of Badr, on one side, 1,000 strong, fully armored, state-of-the-art weapons, horses, transportation. And on the other hand, 313 weak. They have no weapons. One or two transport. Barely, hardly any weapons. And if they are, not hard weapons. 313 against 1,000 strong. No argument. It's easy win for the 1,000. Nobody will tell you that the 313 people will beat the 1,000 for Armstrong. There's no way these 313 people can win this war against 1,000 mushrikeen. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the night battle before the battle, he went into on his knees and he begged Allah, Ya Allah, and he cried his eyes out. He cried, Ya Allah, if you do not grant us victory tomorrow, then spread your name. Ya Allah, please grant us victory. He cried and he begged and he made dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And what happened the next day? The 313 against all odds. Unbelievable, unbelievable. It doesn't make any sense. The 313, they overcame the 1,000 mushrikeen. Why? Because they had Allah with them. They had Allah with them. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's power of his dua. Allah with the 313. My dear friends, we need to make dua. We need to make dua like Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made dua at the time of Battle of Badr. We get Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on our side. My dear friends, how low have we fallen? How have we fallen that in the most blessed, one of the most blessed places on earth, in Baytul Maqdis, in the month of Ramadan, in the month of Ramadan, Muslims are praying, they're praying to Allah, they're making boom, they're making sujood, and the enemy of Allah comes, and they throw them out of the masjid, they make them break the salah, and they kick them out of Baytul Maqdis. How low have we fallen in the eyes of Allah? Nobody can do anything. And they display this every Ramadan. Yet we can't do anything. This is how weak we are. Like the billions of Muslims around the world, despite the trillions of money that we have in our accounts, despite all the glory that we have, all the power that we have, we can't do anything. And they come in the most blessed time of the year, in the most blessed place, performing the most blessed prayer, and they kick you up, and they hurt you, and they kick you. There are people in China whose iman has been forcefully extracted from their hearts. Children have been indoctrinated. People are being made to eat pork, and so they lose their iman. Forget the kalima. Forget Allah. My brothers and sisters, we need dua. We need to beg to Allah, we need to beg to Allah, Ya Allah, use this month to cry, shed tears in front of Allah, beg to Allah, Ya Allah, please, please Allah, help us. Ya Allah, please help us. Ya Allah, save Baytul Maqdis. Ya Allah, save Haramain Sharif, protect Haramain Sharif. Baytul Maqdis worth dying for, crying for, fighting for, making dua for. Baytul Maqdis, for those who have been, you will witness something unique, almost American. Your Imam Sahib is being, yes? He takes groups. Ask him. You know, when you go, despite the turmoil outside Baytul Maqdis, despite the heavy, heavy presence of these Israeli armies with weapons in their hands, being annoying, as much annoying as they can be, and all the stress and anxiety that you feel outside, the tension that you feel outside Baytul Maqdis, once you enter Baytul Maqdis, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. The feeling of peace, the feeling of serenity is unimaginable. I guarantee you that. You sit in Baytul Maqdis, you forget what's going on outside in the world. So much peace and tranquility descends. It is tangible. My brothers and sisters, it's tangible. You feel it. But it's unexplainable. I mean, the land is the land where everyone's fighting for this piece of land. Yet here I am sitting in the masjid and I feel peace. You remember when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam came here? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam was going through the most difficult period of his life. His wife had just passed away, Khadija radiallahu anha passed away. His uncle, Abu Talib, had passed away. They had been through a year where they were boycotting. The Mushrikeen were being very evil. They were going through a very difficult period. Can you imagine the state of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's heart? How sad he was. It was during this year to where? Baytul Maqdis. Where all his grief went away, came to a land of peace. He found peace. And from there, he went to Mi'raj and subhanahu wa ta'ala with a peace part. So this is where Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam found peace. My brothers, we must go and visit this place. We must go and visit. I know I was going to talk about Ramadan. Well, let me tell you, this is worth making dua for, because we know the trouble that's going in the Maqdis. It's a wonderful, wonderful place to visit. I don't know why these people with billions and billions of dollars, they all go to Makkah and Medina. Alhamdulillah, yeah, go. Allah's given you the ability, the time, the ability, and the tawfiq. Yes, go. But why people not go to Baytul Maqdis? It is special. And it has so much relevance and so much. There's so much that you can identify between Makkah and Baytul Maqdis. You see, Baytul Maqdis was built by whom? Anybody? Baytul Maqdis was built by Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam. Who was the Makkah built by? Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam. Which was our first Qibla? Baytul Maqdis. Which is our Qibla now? Makkah Mukarramah. Where is the reward increased? Makkah Mukarramah. Baytul Maqdis. They have so much in common. We have to go and visit this place. When you go there, you will see. A lot of people that were before I went, they said, oh, don't go, you know, there's so much fighting, there's so much shooting, they're trying to put me off, and don't go, be careful. Said, Allah will look after us, inshallah. Many people are going, many people are visiting. My brothers, you will have no difficulty. As long as you have a British passport with you, they can't touch you. In fact, the taxi drivers, the Palestinian taxi drivers, love carrying British passengers. Why? Because when they go through a checkpoint, and the passenger, British passenger, pulls that Muslim British passenger with a full beard, pulls that his British passport, the look on the Jewish soldier's face, the taxi driver loves it. He said, I can pay you to see his face again like that. They really enjoy it. You've got nothing to worry about. It's a strange place. When you go to Bayt al-Maqdis, the Bayt al-Maqdis, Bayt al-Maqdis, how can I say to you that it's a place where the Jews, they believe they have certain, you know, certain rights over. But you know, the Jews, they can't enter Bayt al-Maqdis. The Jews are not allowed to enter Bayt al-Maqdis. It's strange. When you go to Bayt al-Maqdis, there are certain gates. Before you enter the gates, there are about 10 or 15 army personnel with guns standing at the gate. And they say, where are you from? So you say, UK. If they don't believe you, you show them your passport. And if your name is like Buzdar or something, which is not a Muslim name, they still don't believe you. Are you Muslim? So I'm a Muslim. I don't believe your name is Gulzar. Say Surah Fatiha. So you read Surah Fatiha and then they let you in. They're making sure only Muslims enter Bayt al-Maqdis. Jews are not allowed to enter Bayt al-Maqdis. It's forbidden in their law. It's forbidden in their scriptures. They can't enter Bayt. They will become very, very extremely sinful. You see, they believe that within Bayt al-Maqdis, they had a temple. The Temple of Solomon. And in this temple, there was a room which was called the Holies of the Holies. This room contained the asa, the stick, the Torah, the tablets of Musa alayhi salam, and all of the other artifacts were contained in this room. This room was so holy, so pure, that no Jew can enter this room. If any Jew entered this room, he will be damned, he will be cursed, and this is a very, very big sin for them. So no Jew can enter, set foot in the Holies of the Holies. The problem is, when the temple was destroyed, the Holies of the Holy Room was destroyed. Now they don't know where it is. It's somewhere around Bayt al-Maqdis, but they don't know where it is. And by mistake, if somebody went in and they stepped in the Holies of the Holies, they'll be damned, they'll be sinful. So they wrote the law down. Nobody should enter Bayt al-Maqdis in fear that if they enter the Bayt al-Maqdis, they will step in the Holies of the Holies. No! They're instructed to remain in the temple, not fight the Muslims. Their part of their worship is to stand outside Bayt al-Maqdis and cry for your sins that you've committed. Do tawbah. And this wailing wall you hear about, this wailing wall, it wasn't something from their scriptures. No, no, no. The Jews, they used to come around when Sultan the Magnificent, Suleiman the Magnificent, the Sultan, when he was in charge, he noticed that the Jews, they would come around Bayt al-Maqdis and they would stand there and they would cry and they would... And people would, you know, walk over them, push them. They didn't have any place to pray. Suleiman the Magnificent, the Sultan, he said, look, I feel sorry for you. Let me allocate a place for you. And he's the one that allocated the place waiting world. He said, you come down here outside the Masjid al-Baraq, you come outside here, and you pray here, and no one shall disturb you. Allahu Akbar, after a few years, they call it theirs now. Oh, it's our temple now. It's become our temple. This was our outer temple. And it's become theirs. We were having mercy upon them, and they took it by oppression. Bayt al-Maqdis in Hebron, there is a masjid called Masjid al-Khalil. This is where Ibrahim alayhi salam is buried. It's a very special mosque. Why so special? The masjid is a big masjid, mashallah, big masjid. In this masjid, so this is the Qibla. In this masjid, behind the Qibla, Hazrat Ishaq alayhi salam and his wife is buried. Behind Ishaq alayhi salam is Ibrahim alayhi salam and his wife Sarah alayhi salam is buried. Behind Ibrahim alayhi salam, Yaqub alayhi salam and his wife masjid. Masjid. For many years it's been a masjid. And then when the Jews came, they said it's theirs. Yaqub alayhi salam belongs to them. It's their prophet, it's their forefather. He's Israel. His name is Israel, and Bani Israel means the children of Israel, they call him Israel. Yaqub alayhi salam's nickname was Israel. It's their forefather, so they have all right over this masjid, and a battle ensued. And then they came to some kind of agreement. Okay, you can have one third of the masjid. And so they took over one third and gave the remaining two thirds to the Muslims. Then one day one of these Australian Jews came and started shooting in the masjid, and then they had to shut the masjid down, and then when they reopened it, they've taken 60% of the masjid. So now you see the masjid, they've built a wall, so I said Ishaq alayhi salam and Ibrahim alayhi salam, right? They've built a wall in a partition in the masjid over the grave of Ibrahim alayhi salam. So now the Muslims can only see Ishaq and half of Ibrahim alayhi salam. And the Jews, they've taken Yaqub alayhi salam completely, they've taken half of Ibrahim alayhi salam, and they've taken Yusuf alayhi salam. And they've put in airports. You have to go through so many turnstiles, empty your pocket, show your passport, you know, strip search. So when I went, once I went, they did strip search on them. They check everything. And this is a masjid. Subhanallah, we come in this masjid, we pray salah, we leave. Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah, not there. So it's a place worth visiting. May Allah grant peace to the peace of people of Palestine. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect the Muslims of Palestine. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant strength to the Muslims of Palestine. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help and support the people of the Palestine. Make dua for them. Always make dua, especially for the Muslims. Weird of my topic of fasting. Let me quickly say one thing so that at least I can get some benefit from what I'm saying, inshallah, fasting. My dear brothers, fasting is a very, very powerful weapon. And it is very, very important in this age. And this is the last thing I'll say before I let you go. I know you're tired. Fasting is one of the most powerful weapons and the most useful weapons that we have against today's greatest fitna. Today's greatest fitna, what is the today's greatest fitna? Atheism. Now, I'm calling it atheism because we all understand it as atheism. They don't believe in any God. They have no God. They don't worship anything. But they're not really atheists. They have a God. They worship their nafs. They worship their nafs. Agree or not? They worship their nafs. Their nafs is their God. Because they believe we're not restricted by any laws of God or some other supernatural being. We want to do whatever we want to do. Hence this homosexuality and all this, what do you call it, whatever. This was created from the idea that we can do whatever we want to do. This is called nafs parasti. Worship, your worshiping of the nafs. This is the greatest fitna. This is the greatest disease in a Muslim's hand, in a Muslim's heart. This come together. And they go again, and they make you, they bring so many kind of diseases, and they're all internal diseases. These are more severe and more poisonous and dangerous than the illness, the physical illness that we can see from the outside. We have a headache, we have some pain here, or the physical, we go to the doctor. But there are more dangerous diseases inside the heart. Hatred, malice, jealousy, greed. Greed. We want, I want, we want, I want. Throughout the entire year, it's all about I want and what we want. We go out to work, I want this, I want better wages. I want a better position, I want better house, I want a better car, I want better food, I want this and I want that, I want my son to have that, or my daughter to have that, I want that, I want, I want, I want, I want, I want, I want. What are they that I want? We all, because we want to feed our... We become like animals. What are the true primary instincts in an animal? The two desires that it wants to satisfy. One is food, it wants to satisfy, it wants to eat, and it wants to mate. These are the two only desires the animal has, and it will go to any length to satisfy those two desires. We human beings are very similar in that sense. We also have two desires, two primary desires. To feed and to mate. Fasting, and you don't make it. Animals can't fast. Animals don't fast. That's what differentiates from being animals. But Allahu Akbar, we have become worse than animals. We have become worse. We are feeding our nafs so much. We become so greedy. And you know this social media, if think about it, everything we do is about feeding these two desires. If you think about all the things that you do, most of the things that you do satisfy these two primary desires. And the social media, it kind of more. ammunition. Yeah, be free. Look at the videos. Astaghfirullah. You know, I don't know, people start scrolling through videos and they think they've spent 5 minutes and they realize they've spent half an hour, 1 hour scrolling through videos. It goes like that. And you might think, no, I'm being safe. I don't look at anything bad. I don't look at any bad images. I don't look at pornography. No. My brothers and sisters, when you flick through those videos and your eyes are fallen onto an image that you should not be seeing, and then you're like, oh, it's too late. Oh, I shouldn't be looking at that. I just flicked through it. Too late. Your eyes have already sucked that into your mind and into your heart. And it affects your mind and heart. It darkens your heart. You know this greed, it feeds into your greed. Children are watching these and they're becoming morbid. I want to become like this. And when they realize they can't, they go and commit suicide. They throw themselves under a train. My dear brothers and sisters, it's a very, very dangerous weapon. The disease that we face today, this greed, nafsi khaisha, teaches you control those two primary desires. Everything else will follow suit. If you can control these two, you're going to control, maintain your desires, control your desires. Discipline. The world is not about I want. The world is about, thank you Allah, you gave me lots, Allah. Thank you Allah. I should be appreciative of what I have. I said, finally, brother, just one second thing. Donate. Ya Allah, my brothers, donate. Ya Allah, my sisters, donate. Please, give as much as you can. At the time of Ramadan, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to be generous like the wind. The brothers came here, they asked for some money. You know, in Ramadan, we're bombarded. If you know what we use the word bombarded, we're bombarded with all these offers. Donate here. Donate to this madrasa. Donate to this orphanage. Donate to this. My brothers, don't think this is a burden. Don't think, oh, why do you keep coming? Don't think. Think of it as an opportunity. On the day of Qiyamah, when Allah calls you and says, why didn't you do this? Why haven't you got good deeds? Do you remember this? They came from that charity, they came from this charity, this man asked you, this sister asked you, he asked you, they asked you. Oh, did you donate? You never donated a penny. What did you say then? Ya Allah, you give me the opportunity. How are you going to answer to all those people, all those bombarding, you say from bombarding with all these messages about donations? How are you going to answer to Allah on the day of Qiyamah that you had the opportunity but you missed it? But if these opportunities come across, try to donate. You don't know. You might donate £1 or £1 or £5. Who knows? This £5 that you've donated with such sincere heart, with such love, that it becomes beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah loves your £5 donation because of your £5 donation. You don't know. When you donate, it reduces the anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We committed so much sins, Allah is angry with us. Allah is upset with us. If you donate, Allah's anger will reduce it. And brothers, sisters, let's stop committing sins. Let's make this firm intention, Ya Allah, from today. I want to stop committing sins. It's enough. Time is enough now. That's enough. We've done so much. We've gone so far. We've gone so far committing sins. How much more are you going to disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? How much more angry do you want to make Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Is he not angry enough with us? Have we not done enough wrong to him? It's about time we stopped committing sins. In the month of Ramadan, the biggest lesson that we get is stop committing sins. Do tawbah. Tawbah, sincerely tawbah. We all are sinful. Everybody's sinful. But if you just close your eyes and look into your heart and you are regretful, you are remorseful, Ya Allah, I committed this sin, Ya Allah. I'm so sorry, Ya Allah. I was wrong. I was absolutely wrong in doing this deed, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, please, out of your mercy, please forgive me. And ask Allah, beg Allah to forgive you. Ya Allah, please forgive me. Shed some tears. Ya Allah, please forgive me. Please forgive me. You are the most merciful. There's nothing more merciful than you, Ya Allah. You are the merciful one. Ya Allah, please forgive our sins. My brothers, trust me on this. Do that tawbah tonight and see how you feel afterwards. See how you feel afterwards. You must be remorseful and you must promise not to commit again. And see how you feel. Inshallah.
Inshallah.
Inshallah. Everyone say inshallah. Inshallah, from today, you're going to make tawbah that you will not come and see, inshallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant. I'm sorry, I took so much of your time. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Oh, no, you always like most of the time as I could. If you want to visit my tarabi, you can come to Milton Keynes. I need tarabi down there. But make dua for me, inshallah. Make dua for me. Make dua for yourself. Make dua for your family. Make dua for your parents. Make dua for the entire Muslim ummah. Make dua, make dua, make dua. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept all our good deeds. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the strength and ability to continue doing good deeds and taking the most out of that until the day of Eid, inshallah. Until the day of Eid, inshallah. اللهم آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب. ربنا إنك جامع الناس ليوم لا ريب فيه إن الله لا يخلف الميعاد. اللهم إنا نسألك علما نافعا ورزقا واسعا وشفاء من كل داء. اللهم اشف مرضانا اللهم اشف أنت الشافي لا شفاء إلا شفاءك شفاء لا يغادر سقما. اللهم إنا نسألك من خير ما سألك منه نبيك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم ونعوذ بك من من شر ما استعاذ منه نبيك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. أنت المستعان عليك البلاغ ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. يا الله أو مسكر يا الله يا the most merciful يا الله يا الله يا the most beneficent يا الله يا the most kind. والله we are extremely sinful يا الله. We have committed all types of sins. Saghira sins, kabira sins. Ya Allah, we are extremely sinful. We are drowned in sins, Ya Allah. We ask you that you forgive our sins. Ya Allah, please forgive us. Ya Allah, we put our hands before you. Our hands are empty hands, Allah. Don't return us with empty hands, Allah. Grant us forgiveness on this blessed night and this blessed month of your performing Salatul Taraweeh. Ya Allah, we ask you that you forgive our sins. Ya Allah, please forgive our sins. Ya Allah, please forgive the sins of our parents. Ya Allah, please forgive the sins of our brothers and sisters. Ya Allah, please forgive the sins of our relatives. Ya Allah, please forgive the sins of the entire Muslim Ummah. Ya Allah, please protect the Muslim Ummah. Ya Allah, protect the Muslim Ummah. Ya Allah, protect the Haramain Sharifain. Ya Allah, protect Baitul Maqdis. Ya Allah, please protect the Muslims in Palestine. Ya Allah, protect the Muslims in India, in Sri Lanka, in Bangladesh, wherever in the world the Muslims are suffering, Ya Allah, grant them relief. Ya Allah, grant them protection. Ya Allah, grant them relief. Ya Allah, grant them protection. Ya Allah, grant them peace. Ya Allah, and those enemies who are against Islam, Ya Allah, if they have Iman, if they have iman in their taqdeer, Ya Allah, make them into Muslims. And if they don't have Iman, Ya Allah, destroy them. Ya Allah, remove them. Ya Allah, remove them. Allah, make the Muslim life easy, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, strengthen our Iman. Ya Allah, strengthen our Iman. Ya Allah, protect our children. Ya Allah, protect our children. Ya Allah, protect our children. Protect us from all sinful acts, Ya Allah. Protect us from the shaitan. Protect us from the shaitan mardud. Ya Allah, allow us to do good deeds, Ya Allah. Allow us to do good deeds. Allow us to follow the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ya Allah, allow us to recite the Quran. Ya Allah, make Quran our best companion. Ya Allah, make the Quran our best companion. Ya Allah, allow us to love the Quran. Ya Allah, allow us to love the Quran. Ya Allah, allow us to act upon the Quran. Ya Allah, bring us blessings in our life through the Quran. Ya Allah, forgive our parents. Ya Allah, Rabbi irhamhuma kama rabbayani saghira. Ya Allah, those parents who have passed away, Ya Allah, Ya Allah, have mercy upon their souls. Ya Allah. Ya Allah, have mercy upon their souls. Ya Allah, grant them Jannah. Ya Allah, enlighten their graves. Ya Allah, make their graves into a piece of Jannah. Ya Allah, and those parents who are alive, Ya Allah, allow us to serve them, Allah. Allow us to make them happy, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, grant them a long, blessed, happy life, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, there are many people, all ill people all around the world, Ya Allah. There are people who are mentally ill. Ya Allah, there are people physically ill. Ya Allah, there are people who are spiritually ill. Ya Allah, grant them all of them cure, Ya Allah. Make them better, Ya Allah. Grant them good health, Ya Allah. Remove the illnesses from the heart, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, remove the illnesses from the heart, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, allow us to become worthy of Allah, Ya Allah. Allow us to become your worthy. Ya Allah, allow us to become your friend. Ya Allah, allow us to become your good servant, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, accept our du'as. Allah, accept our tarawih. Ya Allah, accept our recitation. Ya Allah, accept our speech here today, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, allow us to act upon the things that have been discussed today, Ya Allah. Allah, Ya Allah, accept our fasting. Ya Allah, finally, when we die, Ya Allah, when we die, make the moment that we die the most blessed moment in our entire life, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, when we die, allow us to say, La ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah. Ya Allah, allow us to die with Iman. Ya Allah, allow us to die with Iman. Ya Allah, do not let us die until you are pleased with us, Ya Allah. Allah, don't take us from this world. Ya Allah, don't take us from this world without Iman. Allah, we can't. We cannot face the Jahannam, Ya Allah, we cannot face the Jahannam, we cannot face your punishment, Ya Allah, not for one moment, not for one second, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, don't take us from this world without Iman, and save us from the blazing fire of Jahannam. Ya Allah, save us from the adab of Qabr. Ya Allah, save us from the adab of Jahannam. Ya Allah, save us from all forms of punishment, Ya Allah. Enter us into Jannah without reckoning. Ya Allah, enter us into Jannah without reckoning. Ya Allah, enter into Jannah without reckoning. ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم وصلى الله تعالى على خير خلقه محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين برحمتك يا رب العالمين.